No, but what I mean is that if you're a writer, isn't one of the things that defines what you are that you are gifted in that direction?
Depends how you're defining it. I have no natural talent. I could never write a letter. I could never draw a line. I was not an exceptional mechanic. I was never an exceptional athlete. No natural talent. I mean natural talent, like some people pick up a pencil, give them a piece of paper, they draw.
You had a talent for staying alive.
That, yeah. You know, or they write poems, or they can write lovely letters and things like that. Nothing. But I had this obsession to do something with my life. I didn't want to waste it. And so I came home every night and wrote and wrote. And I went through reams and reams of papers. Like this one part of Last Days, Trollor, it's about 20 pages long. It took me 2.5 years. I just sat and wrote over and over and over, throw it away, write it in. And I got so involved with the people that I created that when I finished the piece of work, I'd be in bed for a week or two. I'd clunk out at the typewriter. You know, I just totally obsessed with doing something with my life.
Now, both Last Exit Brooklyn and Requiem for a Dream are what almost anyone would call very dark pieces. Why are you attracted to the dark?
Now, I suppose that I know more about the darkness than the light. And it's easier to write about the darkness than the light.
Why?
Because I know more about it. And what is the point? See, unless I can relate to the suffering of people, I cannot offer a solution to the suffering. When I was about 8 or 10 years old, I had my first goal, first ambition, was to end the pain in the world. I was serious. I don't think it was just a... I don't know why, but evidently I saw the world filled with pain. And that's all I saw, was people hurting each other, killing each other, beating each other, just pain everywhere, reading about. And then of course, that was during the Depression, and the war came, it got even worse. Things that people don't. And I couldn't understand it as a child. I still don't, but, well, maybe I do to some extent. But I'm very familiar with this darkness from an inner point of view, I think primarily because I started dying at such an early age, and also from an outward point of view of when you have this awareness of anything internally, you perceive that externally. And we really do, I believe, create the world that we live in. If I remember correctly, the word I, physical I, the Sanskrit root and the Hebrew root, I believe, is ayin, meaning fountain. In other words, this is not an organ that's receiving vibrations from what's out there and going through the brain and interpreting. It's a projector. We project it. So the world that I live in, I'm projecting. So it seems to me that if I'm have such an inner awareness of darkness, that's what I'm going to perceive, is darkness. So I became, not consciously, but I became obsessed with learning how to write and learning how to get as deep into the darkness as possible and then bring it back. And say, okay, here's the problem. I'm not giving you any answer, but here is the problem. Here's the darkness. Now what do you want to do about it? That's not consciously what I was about, but that's kind of what I ended up doing. Because the first four books are pathological without any catharsis, any relief, any answer. But if what has happened is something very, very amazing. During these years, I've talked with thousands of people who have gotten letters. And there is one thing, one word that everyone uses with reference to my work, and that's compassion. And they found within himself the compassion and ability to not judge the people that ordinarily they would judge into the grave. Suddenly they have compassion for these people, which is extraordinary. And that's not what I set out to do. But evidently that's a result, because I hear that from so many people. So the First World Books are an attempt to really look at the darkness in as many different ways as I could. Then I wanted to not only go from the darkness to the light, but to show how you get from the darkness to the light. See, I've never wanted to just tell a story. I wanted to put the reader through an emotional experience. And I believe the reason for that is that I've always been a frustrated teacher and a frustrated preacher. And I've known that. You know? So I'm very consciously do I work to keep that out of my writing. Because I believe that the writer has no business being there, that the ego has to go. And that's certainly something you understand as an artist. Saying the ideal is to get rid of you, right? And I believe I don't have the right to put me, the ego, between the people in the story and the reader. They should have an interrelationship and experience each other. Because if you really want to teach, you have to do it emotionally. What is it? The intellect doesn't, it can get a whole bunch of information, but it doesn't turn it into wisdom. And it's wisdom that we need if we're going to save ourselves, our souls, and this bloody thing here. We need wisdom.